pursuit up to. Do not handle, do not taste, do not touch. You know what? It's almost like he uses the argument that I use for my kids, right? He's saying, that's what you're sounding like. Well, like my kids, it feels like you follow them around all the time saying, hey, don't do that, don't touch that, don't eat that. Like, I'm not going to tell you which one it was, but we had one little one, and every time we went outside, we had to put the dog food in it, okay? And listen, it's not just because the kid played with it, all right? They had a pallet for dog food, okay? And so I'm out here like, don't put that in your mouth. Don't pick that up. You're not going to bed without brushing your teeth. You're not walking out of the house dressed like that. This is the argument that Paul uses. He's almost mocking this church. This church here, as they've forgotten that the focus should be on Jesus, and they've let rules and they've let the law creep in. Now look what he's going to say about this in verse 23. These have indeed an appearance of wisdom in promoting self-made religion and asceticism and severity to the body. You know, another way you can translate this, when he says that this has an appearance of wisdom, you know, another way you can translate that? That makes sense. That's the Okie translation. Makes sense. Right? Like how many times have you heard, this is why we do something, we are against this, we are for this, and you're like, well, that doesn't exactly say, it doesn't say that in Scripture, and then someone makes a pretty good argument, well, here's why we do this. You're like, well, that makes sense. Do you know that Proverbs 14 tells us that there is a way that seems right to man, and in the end, death. patience and more time going after their heart, going after their mind. And so that's what Paul says here. Let's move on to chapter 3. Move on to chapter 3 and verse 1. It says, if you've been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For
was so important because they were a few of the pillars of our family. In fact, my aunt was the godliest woman I think I've ever met. Taught me how to pursue the Lord, taught me how to hear from the Lord. My grandmother was godly. Last year, we celebrated the homegoing of these two ladies. Now, it's interesting. In the book of John, Jesus says that those of us who are those who belong to God, he says that they will never taste death. You ever wondered about that? I've wondered about that. Because I see those in Christ who have lived past life. Those who are in Christ will never taste death. You know what I think that means? At the very end, maybe unknowingly to everyone in the room other than the person who's about to go, they get down to their last breath. Maybe Jesus himself shows up and says, "Way down here." Just takes us home. Verse 4 says that when Christ, who is your life, appears, you will appear with him in glory. Let me tell you that is true. But the opposite of that is also true, okay? When Christ, if he's not your life, appears, you will not be with him. Ask you, is he your life? Not did you pray a prayer once, not do you come to church occasionally. Is Christ your life? Because that's when we appear with him in glory when he comes. And so I want to make an appeal to you today. If you've not given your life to Christ, to be saved, today is the day of salvation. Don't play the game. Don't play the game. Well, I think I've done enough. Give him your life. There's a wonderful exchange that takes place when we give him our life. So it's verse 3 that we're raised with him. We see things about where Christ is. Verse 3, that our lives are hidden with him. We trade our old sinful life to real life. Every life to Christ, and so the appeal is to be saved. If you're already a Christian, the appeal is to focus on Jesus more than the rules. If you are a Christian, the appeal is to focus on the mind more than the actions. Because where our minds go, our actions will come follow. Let's pray. I'm really grateful that you came and you satisfied.